St. Melchiades, Pope, Martyr, 314. Pope Melchiades was Pope of the Catholic Church from 311 to his death in 314. It was during his pontificate that Emperor Constantine I issued the Edict of Milan in 313, giving Christianity legal status within the Roman Empire. The Pope also received the Palace of Empress Fausta, where the Lateran Palace, the papal seat and residence of the papal administration, would be built. At the Lateran Council, during the schism with the Church of Carthage, Melchiades condemned the rebaptism of apostatized bishops and priests, a teaching of Donatus Magnus. The year of Melchiades' birth is unknown, but it is known that he was of North African Berber descent and, according to the Liber Pontificalis, compiled from the 5th century onwards, a Roman citizen. Melchiades and his successor, Sylvester I, were part of the clergy of Pope Marcellinus. It has been suggested that he was party to the alleged apostasy of Pope Marcellinus, which was repudiated by Augustine of Hippo. This view originated from letters, dated to between 400 and 410, written by Donatist Bishop Petilianus of Constantine, who claimed that Marcellinus, along with Melchiades and Sylvester, surrendered sacred texts and offered incense to Roman deities. In April 311, the Edict of Toleration was issued in Sardica, modern-day Sofia, Bulgaria, by the Roman Emperor Galerius, officially ending the Diocletianic persecution of Christianity. The election of Melchiades to the papacy on the 2nd of July 311, according to the Liberian Catalogue, marked the end of a sede vacante, the vacancy of the papacy, following the death of Pope Eusebius on the 17th of August 310 or 309 according to Liber Pontificalis not long after his exile to Sicily by the Emperor Maxentius. After his election, church property that was confiscated during the Diocletianic persecution was restored by Maxentius. This order, however, probably did not extend to all of the parts of Maxentius' jurisdiction. The Liber Pontificalis attributed the introduction of several later customs to Melchiades, such as not fasting on Thursdays or Sundays, although subsequent scholarship now believes the customs likely predated Melchiades. Melchiades prescribed distribution of portions of the bread consecrated by the Pope at all of the churches around Rome, the fomentum, as a sign of unity. In October 312, Constantine defeated Maxentius at the Battle of the Melvian Bridge to become emperor. He later presented the Pope with the Palace of Empress Fausta, where the Lateran Palace, the papal residence and seat of central church administration, would be built. Being the first Pope under Constantine, his pontificate coincided with the peace Constantine gave to the church. In February 313, Constantine and Licinius, emperor of the eastern part of the Roman Empire, agreed to extend tolerance of Christianity to Licinius' territory, proclaimed by the Edict of Milan. Consequently, Christians not only attained the freedom of worship, but also all places of Christian worship were restored and all confiscated property returned. During Melchiades' tenure as pontiff, a schism over the election of Bishop Cecilianus split the Church of Carthage. The opposing parties were those of Cecilianus, who were supported by Rome, and of Donatus, mainly clergymen from North Africa who demanded that schismatics and heretics be rebaptized and reordained before taking office, the central issue dividing Donatists and Catholics. The supporters of Donatus appealed to Constantine and requested that judges from Gaul be assigned to adjudicate. Constantine agreed and commissioned Melchiades together with three Gallic bishops to resolve the dispute, the first time an emperor had interfered in church affairs. Melchiades, unwilling to jeopardize his relationship with the emperor, but also unwilling to preside over a council with an uncertain outcome, changed the proceedings into a regular church synod and appointed an additional 15 Italian bishops. The Lateran Council was held for 3 days from 2 to the 4th of October 313. The process was modeled on Roman civil proceedings, with Melchiades insisting on strict rules of evidence and argument. This frustrated the Donatists, who left the council without presenting their case, which led Melchiades to rule in favor of Cecilianus by default. The council thus ended after only 3 sessions. The Pope retained Caecilianus as Bishop of Carthage and condemned Donata's teachings of rebaptism of bishops and priests. The adverse rulings failed to stop the continuing spread of Donatism across North Africa. The Donatists again appealed to the Emperor, who responded by convening the Council of Arles in 314, but it too ruled against the Donatists. By the time the council was convened, Melchiades had died and had been succeeded by Sylvester I. He was buried in the catacomb of Calixtus at the Appian Way and venerated as a saint. Licinius, who promulgated the Edict of Milan, violated the edict in 320 by persecuting Christians, sacking them from public offices, forbidding synods and condoning executions. A civil war broke out between him and Constantine, with Constantine eventually defeating him in 324. The feast of Melchiades in the 4th century, according to the Martyrologium Hieronymianum, was celebrated on the 10th of January. In the 13th century, the feast of Saint Melchiades was included, with the qualification of martyr, in the general Roman calendar for a celebration on the 10th of December. In 1969, the celebration was removed from that calendar of obligatory liturgical celebrations, and moved to the day of his death, the 10th of January, with his name given in the form mittits, but without the indication of martyr. Amen.